Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In our last video, we had to remove some rotten core in the cockpit floor, which is the mounting point for our newly refurbished engine bay cover. We then added fresh balsa core, and we are now ready to add new layers of fiberglass and some small plywood supports for added strength, so we can then fit our new engine bay cover. Okay, so I've just cut some little supports out of plywood, and I've popped a screw in here as well. This is a stainless steel screw. So what we're going to do is thicken up some polyester resin, and then I'll be able to screw that into position, fillet it, and then I'll be able to go straight over with some fiberglass and some polyester resin. Right, that didn't go according to plan at all. It is the next day and we just had to abort yesterday. It was just too hot. 32 degrees, unusually warm for here in the UK. Yeah, and the resin, although it's catalyzed at 1%, was just going off far too quick, and we've just ended up with a bit of a mess here, which I need to sand off and clean up. And then we didn't actually get to put any glass down here at all. We literally just got one layer on here, and it was just setting up so fast that yeah, we just had to stop. So a lot cooler this morning, 20 degrees, so a lot better temperature. So what I'm gonna have to do is just clean up these pokey bits, and then we will give it all a quick sand and acetone, and then we'll come in and get some more layers on. So that glassing is now done, so we'll just leave that to set up. So back down in the workshop, and Richard has been working on this engine cover. So we took this over to Melt and Fiberglass after we'd done all the reinforcing work on it, and he's given this a coat of gel coat. He's sprayed the gel coat on. So what we're doing now is just flatting and polishing this. There's a little bit of orange peel in it, so we're going to give this a flat with some 320, work up through the grades, 400, 600, 800 to 1000, and then we'll be able to come in with the mop and get this all polished to a nice finish. In fact, we've done this side already, and you can see that is turned out pretty well, and this was the finish that we got from the spray, so quite dull and quite orange peely. So yeah, with a little bit of work we can get it to look like new. Wow, a couple of hours of flatting, wet sanding, polishing, and this has turned out really, really nice. Just looks like a new part. We've flatted and polished this channel here, this front face here, and this side face here, because they'll all be on show. And then we've got underneath the seat, we've also done the back edge here and these side pieces, the channel, but we've actually left this top piece because this needs cutting out. And there'll be a storage bin that drops into that. So no need to flatten polish that. And same deal with this here as well. This is going to have teak on it. So both those areas we can leave. And we've also done in here, which is where the engine access hatch sits. Polished all that up and that all looks really nice. And also on the back edge here, which is actually, this actually pokes out the back of the boat just here. So this edge here will be on show. So that's all done. Everything else we don't need to worry about. So yeah, really happy with the way this has turned out. Lovely gloss, and that really is absolutely spot on. Okay, so today we're back on preparing this engine cover area. So we've repaired our damp balsa under here, so we've put in some new core here and some new layup, and then while we were at it, we laid up some more fiberglass on this edge as well, just to strengthen this. We also put in a piece of triangular piece of ply, again just to add a little bit of strength. And I also mixed up some resin with some microfibers and just filled in these holes as well. So obviously we've got the layup on the bottom, and then we've just ground this out on the top off camera and just laid in some microfiber mixed with resin in here. And what we'll need to do is just remove the tape, knock these all back, and then we'll be able to apply some gel coat onto these. And we also need to trim off this excess fiberglass. Okay, so I've trimmed the fiberglass off the bottom here, and then I've used the sander with 120 grit just to sand all the way along the bottom. And in fact, I've actually measured this height here, and I've cleaned that up completely as well, so we've got a nice straight line now, and that is looking really nice. And same over here as well, so I've come to about here. Still needs a little bit of finishing off this side, but that's looking a lot better. And I can show you under here where the new layup is, so you can see here that this layup now is a lot thicker, so that is nice and sturdy, and that goes all the way along the bottom here and all the way down here. And this piece actually that sticks out here, this continues on, so there's a piece of floor here and then there's some seating here, and that's why we want to make sure that this is nice and sturdy. And then what I've also done is just cleaned out these holes, dish those out with the little sanding disc, 120 grit, so that's now ready to take some gel coat. So all I need to do now is give that just a quick wipe with acetone and mix up some gel coat and get that into those holes. So I'm back on the boat this morning. Yesterday we popped in the gel coat repairs, so just popped some little blobs of gel coat in here and left those raised, and then I've just gone back this morning quickly and just knocked those back with some 180 grit. Now that has left some little sort of circular sort of halos around here, so we'll probably ideally this one's coating in gel coat again, but actually this is going to be hidden under the floor, so that's probably as far as we'll go with that. But I have got these edges to do. So I've got this edge here, and I've got these edges down here to do as well. So I'm just going to block those back quickly.
Bye.
So just use the block with some 320 grit just to block these flat surfaces here, here and here, and then just hand sanded carefully the corners with some 320, and then I went back up through the grades, so 600 and 1000, and then just polished it, and that is looking massively better than it did before, so really pleased with that. Still need to carry on along here. It was a bit of a test piece this, so still got some chipping here, so I need to drop some more gel coat in these chips here, and again we can get this looking really nice. I think did also sand inside this corner here, but that's, I've rubbed through, so that needs gel coating again as well, but that's fine, we can come back and do that, not a problem. And so what we're going to do now is, now I've got this area flat, we've got our engine bay cover, we're going to do a quick test fit and see how that fits. Alrighty guys, so we've got our new engine bay covering, or refurbished engine bay cover. So that's this area here, across here, and then over onto this ledge where we repaired the holes. And then we've also just dropped in the new engine bay cover as well, which we had fabricated. So we made the mold for this, and Melton Fiberglass molded that for us. They charged us £80 for that part, so really reasonably priced. I think he charged us £50 to actually refinish this as well, so really reasonable, and that's turned out really well. Really happy with that. So what we'll do now is we'll take this out. We wanted this in place just so that when we paint the top, it'd just be a lot safer for us moving around. There's this great big hole here that was here before, and Richard's already been down there once, and yeah, it was quite a danger, so to have this in place is brilliant. So what we're going to do now is take the engine cover back up, we'll put that into storage somewhere, we might even drop the old one in for now, and then what we're going to do is just bolt through this seating area here and bolt that into place and see how that looks. Okay, so those bolts are in, so we've got four across the back here. These are just temporary fixings, to be honest, because this will need to come back out again, but it's holding it in place nicely. We've got one in the corner, we need to do one more here, and then we're just working on now getting this joint here lined up. So we've got a brace just here, just pushing that way, so this is nice and flat here, and it's also nice and flat in here. So what we'll do now is we'll drill some holes underneath here. I think in the factory boat they either had 3 or 4 6mm bolts, so we'll get those drilled. So our engine cover is fixed into place, guys, and what a difference that has made. That looks absolutely brilliant. So nice to get that in. So we've got three bolts holding it through here and three bolts holding it through here, and all of the surfaces are nice and flush. Nice corner here, and we've got nice consistent gaps down the edges as well, and the color match is really good as well. The color match on the back edge here is really nice, considering this is what, 12-13 year old gel coat, and this is brand new gel coat. But yeah, it looks really good, and same over here as well. Again, really nice match, so really pleased with that. This edge here's worked out really well, nice and flush down the side here, so that's really pleasing to get that in. What we will do is we'll either use the old engine hatch, or we'll use a bit of ply just to cover that up. But you know, just to step over there is no problem at all. We've been having to step over this huge gap and it's not been that safe, so this is nice and safe now. We can walk around here safely, which means we can now work on our roof, and we've got the paint come through for that as well finally now, so that'll be really good to get that roof painted. Okay, that's going to be a wrap for today's video, guys. Hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give us a thumbs up, and we'll see you on the next one.